Well, she got all steamed up after Roach took the skip out and said she was going to do something about it.
Bloody hell!
G'day!
What have you been up to?
Oh, well, I'm real pleased to see you, too.
Laurie just told us about Roach and how you've decided to play the heavy. What's going on?
It's all fixed. Grabbed the stash, chucked it through the security gates. When the screws find it, they'll do a cell search. Maxwell and Williams will lose the lot. Clever little bugger, aren't I?
Bloody little idiot, more like. You better hope you can get that stuff back before the screws find it, otherwise you're going to take a big dip in the popularity stakes. All right, so she might not risk thumping us, but after what we did to Egbert, she's going to get back at us somehow. So we get him first.
How?
By sicking Looney onto her.
No, I've told you before, we're not going to use Melvin.
Just hear me out. Connors is the only thing that keeps that lot together. We knock her off and we're on top. And the only one who can do that's Jonesy.
No.
Look, it's got to happen sometime. And with the governor down on Connors the way she is, the best time's now.
I tell you, business is booming. And I reckon I might have got Waters on side too. She's bought two lots so far, and you should have heard her sound off about Connors when I stirred her over the coke van.
What did she say?
That she wasn't going to take any crud if Rita started getting heavy with her. Should have seen her. She was real dark.
Good work. It's up to all of us to keep working on her. If we can undermine Connors' support enough, we won't need a direct confrontation.
Well, I thought they would have got slack after the last cell search.
Even if they have, they're still using the same hiding place. It doesn't matter. The screws still won't come. What about the girls? The nicotine of fruit or something? The screws aren't going to say, oh, it doesn't matter. We're just... Oh, bloody hell. It's miles away.
Okay, I said I was sorry. Got all steamed up and didn't think.
You never bloody do. Well, hurry up. I haven't got all day.
I'm hurrying, all right.
Next time, do us a favour. Use your brain. Give it a grunt.
How do you reckon they're getting the dough for them?
Stuffed if I know. Just going to have to keep an eye on them.
What's he doing?
Well, we're just...
Oh,
it's you. You keep away from Cass. She's me mate.
Jeez, I can't get away from her.
Never mind her. Just keep your eyes peeled for the screws.
You got it.
Oh, beauty. Well, let's go.
Girl said you want to have a talk to me.
Yeah. I'm told you've been buying coke.
What of it?
Well, for a start, it's bloody stupid. You know what that stuff does to you?
Yeah. It makes me feel good.
While you're on it. But after it wears off, you end up lower than you were before. So you take a bit more to get back up and the whole thing starts all over again. It's a bloody merry-go-round. You saw what happened to Bongo.
Stop it, Reed. Look, I know what I'm doing. It's none of your bloody business anyway.
It's my business if it affects the gang.
It's got nothing to do with the bloody gang.
Wasn't born yesterday, Roach. I know who's supplying it. It's the same two bitches who tried to stuff up Julie's wedding. You buy stuff off them, you're going against the gang.
Come on, Ree. It's just a bit of coke.
You're leaving me nowhere to go, Roach. Now I'm telling you for the last time, no coke.
Get stuffed. Look, I've had a gutful of people telling me what to do in here, and I'm not going to cop it from you.
I've never had to smack under the worry as I'm it for. I'd hate you to be the first.
Then stop telling me what to do.
You're determined not to listen, aren't you?
Yeah. 39. 40.
Spread those legs, 41. Harris. 42. Keep it going, people. 40. Don't slow down.
44. 45. 46. 47. 48. 49. 50.
Okay, people. Spinal twists. Double time. 20 of them. Go.
1.
Oh, come on.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Okay, that's all. Everyone, take a break.
Mrs. Reynolds, what are you doing here?
I was about to ask you the same question.
Mum doesn't know, does she?
No, she doesn't. That's why I'm here. Why haven't you told her?
I knew she wouldn't be keen on the idea. Especially after what happened to Dad. So I thought I'd finish my training first on the basis of what she doesn't know she won't worry about.
And if you wanted to keep it a secret, why did you move in with her?
Well, I heard a couple of the instructors talking about what was happening at Wentworth. Mum getting demoted. So I pretended I'd only just left the Navy and needed somewhere to stay so I could help her over it.
Glad you did. She needed someone. Tell me, why leave the Navy to become a prison officer?
Time for a change. I don't suppose you've got a minute for lunch. I'd like to hear the real version about how Mum's been coping.
As long as you don't expect me to part with too many secrets.
Give us a few minutes for a quick shower and I'll meet you for lunch.
You have got to be joking. I wouldn't even feed that to the freak.
You'd cop life if you did.
Yeah, well, I hope who's ever coming into a place Merv's better cooks than you lot.
Get off on Lexi. I'm sure it'll be lovely.
Hey, look. I thought it was about time you and me had a chat. Alone. I told you to leave, Cattle.
All right, Mel. You go and finish your lunch with Janet. I'll be all right.
Well, I'll be watching you.
Talk.
You're bringing in hard drugs. I want it stopped.
You sound like you're backing down.
I'm worried about the girls. That stuff
can
really
just... You're worried about losing control.
After all, what sort of top dog has the screws just waiting for her to put a foot out of line?
One who's tough enough to stand up to a man.
I know how tough you are.
You made a good job of Roach, didn't you? She must be all of half your size. How many more gang members are you prepared to beat up just because they won't toe the line?
Look, all I'm asking is that you cool it with the heavy dope. In a place like this, that stuff's suicide.
No.
I'd think twice about that if I were you.
I've told you what my answer is.
And if you wish like hell it had been yes.
How? Beat me up? I don't think even you'd be stupid enough to do that, not with the governor just waiting for an excuse to transfer you.
Wentworth, you're kidding.
The memo came through this morning.
Damn. Sorry. Nothing personal. It's just that I wanted to get through training as Marty Jackson, not Meg Morris's son.
Is that because you don't want favouritism or because you don't want comparisons?
Favouritism. If I'm going to make it, it's got to be because I earned it.
Look, I'm sorry if this sounds a bit blunt, but I am worried about having a mother and son together on the staff to the point where I've contacted the department to see if they can make a late change to the postings.
And?
Well, they're considering it, but I got the distinct impression they weren't mad keen on the extra paperwork.
Talk about rotten timing. As if Mum hasn't got enough on her plate without having to worry about me.
I'm sure she'll be fine. I'm also sure it'd be better if she heard it from you.
I've been meaning to tell her, just waiting for the right moment. Guess this is it, eh? Well, I have to get going. Thanks for taking time out to come and see me. I appreciate it, and what you've done for Mum. Well, look forward to working with you.
Bye, Marty.
Relying on that stuff to get you through in here is crazy. You're going to get hooked on it. And that's when that Maxwell bitch can get her claws into you.
You and Maxwell are so bloody worried about who's going to end up on top, you don't give a stuff about the rest of us. But this place is getting to me, Reed. I feel like I've been in here a year already.
Well, it gets to all of us, kid. But there are other ways of keeping on top of it. That's one of the reasons the gang's here.
So where's the gang when Lurch is snoring so bloody much I can't get to sleep? And all I can do is lie there and think about how much I'm missing Bomb. I hate this bloody hole. I mean, look at us now. The gang's all here. We're having a wonderful bloody time, aren't we?
You're starting to sound like you want to give the gang the flick.
Look, all I'm saying is that this place is driving me crazy. And if the gang can't keep me happy, I know what can and where I can get it. And it doesn't matter how much you thump me, you're not going to stop me.
Hello, Rose.
Hi, Rose. Hi, Rose. Hi, Rose. What are you doing?
The power of positive thinking has triumphed. I'm feeling fine. Oh. Sister Hall was amazed at my recovery.
Oh. Sure, you should be up and about. You're looking awfully pale to me.
Don't you dare wish me back into a hospital bed. I've just spent half the morning convincing Sister Hall that I'm well enough and I'm fit.